Population, inversion and laser action. Let us consider a simple case of a material whose atoms can reside in three different states. State E1, which is ground state, the excited state E3, in which the atoms can reside only for 10⁻⁸ seconds, and the metastable state E2, in which the atoms can reside for 10⁻³ seconds, much longer than 10⁻⁸ seconds. A metastable state is an excited state in which an excited electron is unusually stable and from which the electron spontaneously falls to lower state only after relatively longer time. Instead of direct excitation to this state, the electrons are excited to higher level for spontaneous fall to metastable state. Also, let us assume that the incident photon of energy HF is equal to E3 minus E1 raise the atom from the ground state E1 to the excited state E3, but the excited atom do not decay back to E1. Thus, the only alternative for the atoms in the excited state E3 is to decay spontaneously to state E2. The atom reach state E2 much faster than they leave state E2. This eventually leads to the situation that the state E2 contains more atoms than state E1. This situation is known as population inversion. Once the population inversion has been reached, the lasing action of a laser is simple to achieve. The atoms in the metastable state E2 are bombarded by photons of energy HF is equal to E2 minus E1, resulting in an induced emission, giving an intense coherent beam in the direction of the incident photon. The emitting photons must be confined in the assembly long enough to stimulate further emission from other excited atoms. This is achieved by using mirrors at the two ends of the assembly. One end is made totally reflecting and the other end is partially transparent to allow the laser beam to escape. As the photons move back and forth between the reflecting mirrors, they continue to stimulate other excited atoms to emit photons. As the process continues, the numbers of photons multiply and the resulting radiation is therefore much more intense and coherent than light from ordinary sources. I hope now you have full understanding about population inversion and laser action. Please subscribe my channel for more animation.